34 feet separating the two spacecraft, both flying in formation south of New Zealand.
Houston and Station Atlantis on the big loop. We don't see a flyout. We're initiating final approach.
Separating Atlantis from the International Space Station, standing by for contact and capture. Contact, docking confirmed. Capture confirmed at 10:07 a.m. Central Time.
Houston, the Station Atlantis, capture confirmed, and we see free drift.
Station Atlantis, Houston, station free drift is confirmed.
Pilot Doug Hurley confirms the arrival of Atlantis. Everything going very smoothly with the ring retraction that essentially pulls the International Space Station into a hard mate with Atlantis. As you can see from these views from cameras on the truss of the International Space Station, as the two vehicles fly 240 statute miles above the Pacific, moving from southwest to northeast in an orbit inclined 51.6 degrees to either side of the equator.
You see the Expedition 28 crew there taking some pictures. As you can tell, it's not only a historic event for us here on the ground, but also for the crew. There is Commander Chris Ferguson of STS-135 making his way on board the International Space Station. He is greeting the Expedition 28 Commander Andrei Borisenko.
Hey, Sergey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
See you. Hey. Oh, my goodness, my long-lost Japanese friend. How you doing, buddy?
I see,
Big Mike. How you, bud?
Good, man.
Wow.
The pilot, Doug Hurley, making his way on board as well as with the camera. Rex Walheim and Sandy Magnus also floating their way up through the hatches as well. So the entire STS-135 crew now on board the International Space Station. We'll stand by, listen to these crews greet one another.